This no-code AI agent just cleaned my inbox for me. It actually sorts every email into smart categories, things I need to respond to, meeting updates, collab requests, even cold emails and marketing. And if something needs to reply, the AI drafts it for me so I can hit send in seconds. And the best part is I built all this using no-code and a drag and drop tool that you can easily adjust to your needs. It's also really easy to connect to any tool like Gmail or ChatGPT by simply signing in with Google here, for example. So it's really easy to set up. And this is how it works. I have here created 9 labels and instruction how to label them exactly. Based on that information, all my emails get labeled by my AI. One of these labels is to respond. This label triggers my respond agent. He creates me a draft based on the email I receive. I can add many tools to this respond agent by clicking this plus icon. For example, calendar or any other tool available here. And after this tutorial, you also will be able to create workflows like this one. And in case you don't know me yet, I'm Ed. I help small business owners and beginners to get started with AI automation. Inside my school community, I provide everything that you need to get started with AI automation, to get you from a beginner to an advanced user. We cover many topics like clipping automation, marketing agent, voice agent, auto-publishing agent, and so on. Here I also provide templates and instructions that you can simply download and import. Like for example, for the mail agent. Once you download the template, you can simply click create workflow and import it when you click here. This way you can get started much quicker. I created 2 versions of this workflow. The first version gets triggered by every new email that arrives, so it directly gets labeled. The second version is when you set up this workflow for the first time. This workflow gets triggered when I click this button here. Then it gets the last 50 emails I have in my Gmail and labels them one by one. This way I also can quickly check if the instructions here work great for your use case. And the Google Docs document, I also provide the whole prompt for you for free. After a short demo, I will show you exactly how to build this workflow and this workflow step by step. And if you're part of my community, you can directly download both blueprints and import both by clicking here the 3 dots and select import from file. First, let me remove all labels. For example, I click here now, select all emails and select remove labels. And I will do it now for all 9 labels here. All right, I removed now all labels here and now I will start this workflow here. I just need to click here, execute workflow. And start. Now it grabs the last 50 emails from my Gmail and loops them one by one through this whole workflow. What happens first is the AI will now check this email, and based on the prompt that I provided here, it will decide which of these labels are the matching one. And then it will label these emails. When I now reload here my Gmail, you see here the labels. Let me reload again. And like you can see, it will now mark all emails with the correct label. When you click this icon here, you can stop this anytime. But it's not all. Emails that have the label to respond will also go to the respond agent. In this element, we check if the label is to respond. And if it's true, it will go to the response agent here. You can give this respond agent multiple tools, like for example, your calendar. This way, the response agent can also create drafts with available slots in your calendar. We will start with the workflow that gets triggered when a new email arrives. And make sure to stick until the end where I do a full cost breakdown. And make sure to open up the Google Docs document so you can follow along. First of all, we go to n8n.io and create an account here. If you already have one, you can simply sign in. Once you're signed in here, you click create workflow. Then you give this workflow a name like email agent. To add our first step, we click here. Then we select our trigger. For this, we type in Gmail and select here Gmail and then on message received. Here you have first to connect your Gmail. For that you click create new credential. First you have to fill out your client ID and your client secret. Both are pretty easy to obtain. In the video link below, I explain exactly how to get both. Once you filled out both, you click here save and this sign in with Google button appears. You click on this button and select your Gmail account and click allow. If you connected your account successfully, you should see the message account connected. Then you close this here and click fetch test event. Then you will see on the right your last email. But the problem is we don't have here all data because Simplify is activated, so we deactivate it and click again fetch test event. When we click here on schema, you see everything for this email. For example, the current labels or the tags of this email. This information we will use in the next step. We go back to Canvas then and click here the plus icon. Then we type in edit and select edit fields set. This node allows us to reduce the information here to the ones that we need. By clicking here, Here I provide all information that we need in the next step, for example, the sender email. Then I look here on the left where I find the sender email and find it here and drag and drop it here inside. Then I click add field and get the next field I need, in this case the sender name. I can find here. Then I do the same for the email subject that I can find here, and also for the email body that I can find here, and for the mail ID that I can find here. And then I click execute step. This way it's much easier to have the right information that we need in the next step, because having so much options like on the left can be sometimes overwhelming. And then I go back to Canvas and click save. Now we can add an AI agent that decides which label is the correct one for this email by clicking the plus icon here and type in AI agent and select here the AI agent. Under source for prompt, we select define below, and then we copy this snippet here back here. If you use the exact same name like sender email, sender name, and so on, then it should already work. Otherwise, simply delete it here, for example, from, and drag and drop it here. And make sure to select the expression. Next, you have to provide the system prompt. For this, you click here add option and select system message. The system message you can also copy and paste from here. The system message is also the message that you need to adjust if you don't want to use these 9 labels and instead use different ones. Simply adjust this prompt to your needs and go back to Canvas. For our AI agent to work, we need to provide a chat model. For this, we click the plus icon here and select Open Router here on the right. Then you need to provide credentials for Open Router by clicking here Create New Credential. And you need to provide here an API key. For that, you go to openrouter.ai. This service gives us access to any model, for example, Gemini, GPT-5, or Claude Sonnet 4. And it even gives you access to free AI models. Simply create an account here, then add some credits, like $1 or $2, and then click here Keys. Then click Create API Key, give it a name, click Create, and then simply copy this key and add it here and click Save. If everything worked fine, you should see connection tested successfully. Then you close it here and select the AI model that you want to use. I used in this example GPT 4.1 Mini. Each model has different pricing, so make sure to try different models to see which one works for you the best and is the cheapest. Then we go back to Canvas, double click again on this AI agent and click execute step. And now we see already the correct output. But we don't want this output in this text form, we want to split it out in the different elements. For that, we click here require specific output format. Then we go back to Canvas, click here under output parser, the plus icon, and select structured output parser. Here we simply provide an example format in JSON. For that, you can ask ChatGPT, or in this case, we simply can copy and paste it from our Google Docs document that you can find under format and paste it here. Then we go back to Canvas, double click on this AI agent again, and click again execute step. And like you can see, instead of the text form, we now receive different items that we can later drag and drop again, like in the previous steps. The last thing we want to do is to rename this node by clicking here. Important, name the node exactly like here, because otherwise you can't follow along in the next steps. And then you can go back to Canvas and click save. Alright, our AI agent is now able to label our emails correctly. But before we continue, you need to create labels in your Gmail. For that, you go to the Google Docs document and create these 9 categories. For example, you copy this one, click here the plus icon, and paste in the label, and click create. By the way, pro tip, if you don't want these messages to be in your main inbox, you click here the 3 dots, and select in message list, you select hide. To label our email correctly, we need the label ID. This is different than the label itself. For that, you click here the plus icon and type in Gmail and select under label actions, get many labels, and click execute step to make sure it works. When I click now here JSON, I see all labels in my inbox. For example, to respond, marketing, and so on. And each of these labels has a label ID. This we need in the next step. We'll go back to Canvas. But before we can continue, like you can see here 24 items. That means everything what will be after this plus icon here will be executed for each item. But we don't want that. Since we just want to get one label, for that we click here the plus icon and type in aggregate and select under aggregate all item data into a single list and click execute step. That way, now each item is now in one big list. And we go back to Canvas and now we see here just one item. This is an n8n thing and we just need to do that. Then next we click here the plus icon and type in edit fields and select this one. Here we click add field and call it label ID. And for this value, we go to our Google Docs document, scroll down here until we see get label ID and copy and paste it here. When everything worked fine, you should see this here in green. If you don't, that means probably you didn't name this email AI agent this way. And then you click execute step and then go back to Canvas and click save. And now we can finally add the label to our email. For that, we click here the plus icon, type in Gmail, select it here, and then type in label. And select here add label to message. Here we need to provide the message ID and the label ID. The label ID we can provide here from the last field by drag and dropping here. And the message ID we can provide from this node, mail under ID. When I click now execute step, then the label gets added to this message. When you look for this message now in your Gmail, you should see the label here. Now let's go back to Canvas. When we compare now this workflow to the end goal, we have now the first part finished. We just need to add a sticky note. Then we double click to rename it to classifier. Then we select here the blue color, extend it here, put this one up and put all these elements here and click save. And the last thing we have to do is to add our email responder. But this one should be only executed when the label is to respond. For that, we click here the plus icon and select if route here. Then we go to our email agent and drag and drop the item here. Then go back to our Google Docs document and copy this exact name to here and click execute step. In this case, the label is not to respond. Therefore, it falls under the false branch. Now we want to create a workflow in case the message is to respond. But the problem is we don't have any influence which email is received in our Gmail trigger. Therefore, we need to simulate the situation when the message is to respond. For that, I double click on this node and select under is equal to is not equal to. This way, the true branch is now active. Now I click here the plus icon, select here AI and select AI agent. Under source for prompt, I select define below. Then I go to the Google Docs document and simply copy this prompt here and paste it here. This is basically just the email, the subject, the sender, the email body. Then under options, I click add option and select system message. Then I go back to Google Docs again and copy this system message. Important, the better you adjust this system message to your needs, the better the response will be. And the last thing we have to do is to give this AI agent a brain. For that, under chat model, we click the plus icon, type in open router and select here model. In my opinion, Claude Sonnet 4 writes the best emails, but play around with it so you receive the best results and go back to Canvas. Now open again the AI agent and click execute step. And here's the response. Now we go back to Canvas, click the plus icon, select here Gmail and type in here draft and select create a draft. Here we need to provide a subject and a message. For that, under subject, I type this, and then I select here the subject. And for the message, I simply drag and drop the output from the AI agent here. And then I click execute step. When we look now under drafts, we have this draft here that you can then simply send off. By the way, it's also advisable to add here the to email that you can find here in the sender email. That way the draft has already the correct receiver email and go back to Canvas. And the last step is click here the plus icon, type here edit fields, do here nothing, click go back to Canvas, drag it here and connect also the false branch here and click save. Perfect, we just finished this workflow. Now every new message that arrives will be labeled automatically and even the response will be crafted if needed. For this workflow to work all the time, you simply activate it here. Perfect, now all incoming emails are labeled and an answer is drafted if needed. But if you are setting up this workflow for the first time, you want also your previous emails to be labeled. For that, we need the retro run workflow that I showed you at the beginning. And to create this workflow, it's actually pretty easy since we already finished this one. First, we click here the plus icon and select your workflow. Then we call it mail agent retro run. As the first trigger, we choose trigger manually since we want to run this only one time. Then we click the plus icon and search for Gmail and select here get many messages. Here you can set up a limit how many messages you want to be processed. In this case, I just choose 50 and deactivate simplify. Then click execute step. Now n8n got the last 50 messages. We want these messages now to be processed one by one. For that, I click here the plus icon, click here flow and then loop over items. This way now each message is looped one by one. And the best part is we just need to replace this placeholder with our email agent we just created. Simply select this workflow here without the Gmail trigger and copy and paste it here. Then drag it here and connect the loop with the email node here. And this last node here, you connect here. Then you remove this placeholder. And that's it actually. It will now already work. Let me show you. When I click now execute workflow, it gets first the last 50 emails and then it loops them one by one, like you can see here. And so on. Amazing, our automation works now, but how much does it cost to run? In this workflow, we have two costs. The first cost is the hosting of n8n and the second is to running the LLMs. Let's start with how much the LLMs cost. For that, we go to OpenRouter and click here on activity. And here we can see how much it costed to run this workflow. We use 4O Mini to label the emails and it costed around 0.3 till 0.5 cents per email. But it always depends on the length of the email. So it might be a little more or less. And also to respond to the emails where we use Claude Sonnet 4, it was also about 0.3 cents. So depending on your emails, it could cost a little or not. What I also recommend is to test different models to see which one performs best and is the cheapest for you. What you can also try is free models. When you click here on models and then select under prompting price free, you see a bunch of different models that are for free that you can use. That means you are limited how much requests you can send per minute or hour. And the other cost is for n8n. The cost for having a cloud version directly from n8n is around 24 euro per month. But you can also self-host it and then you can bring down the cost to about $5 a month for n8n. I hope you liked this video and see you in the next one.